Okay, I literally need to get going, so make it quick, bitch. Today's a Monday. It's 9:40 in the morning. I woke up at 7 because I just wanted to get up and clean my apartment and get my day started. And I have a really hard time getting up early, so I'm proud of myself for that. I don't know, today I just had a lot of different things that I wanted to talk about. I have a lot of different things that I'm doing today, so I wanted to bring you guys along and hang out with you and talk about some different things that I've been wanting to talk about. I just yesterday got back from being in my hometown for a couple days. I don't really like to go to my hometown, if I'm honest. I love seeing my family and people down there that I love. I live in Northern Utah right now. I live in Salt Lake. I grew up in Southern Utah. And my boyfriend's parents live down there also. So me and my boyfriend went down there together. And whenever I'm down there, I find myself doing a lot of self-reflection because, you know, I grew up there. I have a lot of memories there. I have a lot of bad memories there. I have a lot of people that I left behind. I just am the type of person, I overthink a lot of things. And I think about my past a lot, which, you know, is it healthy? Who knows? I have just been doing a lot of self-reflection. On top of that, on the way home, I was looking through my boyfriend's camera roll because I wanted to. Don't get me wrong, he was sitting right there. He knew that I was doing it. Me and my boyfriend used to Snapchat a lot. And I don't really use Snapchat anymore. If you still use Snapchat and you're over 18, you know what? I can't say shit because I still use it, just not as often as I used to. He just had a lot of screenshots of Snapchats that I would send him. Not like that. Just like outfits and like pictures of myself and stuff that I would send that he like thought were cute that he screenshotted. And I don't really see a lot of old pictures of myself. I have 58,000 photos in my camera roll, so that is disgusting. I just don't see a lot of old pictures in my camera roll because I have so many photos. My boyfriend doesn't, so it was really easy for me to just like, you know, go through like 2 years and 10 minutes and see a lot of old photos of myself and see a lot of old photos of the way that I used to dress and the way that my body looked. And I don't know, it was just really interesting. And you know, when you change, you don't really feel yourself changing, it just happens. Like one day you just are. Like every day you just are who you are. You just gradually change. It sounds like I'm trying to make this deep. I'm not. I actually really need to go to the gym right now because I want to go to the gym. And that's something that I'm going to talk about later, is like gym and eating and all of that sort of stuff. Where was I going with this? One thing that I was noticing when I was looking through my boyfriend's old pictures of me is that my body has changed a lot. And obviously my face and hair and everything else has changed about me too. I don't know, that's just been something that I've been working on for a really long time, is trying to get into really good shape and trying to get the body that I want because I am willing to put in the hard work. I'll touch on all of that later. I have a lash and brow appointment, which I haven't gotten done in a really long time. So I'm really excited to do that. Okay, I'll shut the fuck up now and go to the gym and I'll get some clips. For some reason, my eyes are just low today. Okay, I absolutely had to narrate this because I was going to mention in this video that I have never had an experience like this getting hit on in the gym, and I literally got this on camera and I wish so bad I could leave the audio in, but you see the man behind me. So I'm stretching, minding my own business. He asked if I was making a video and he could see my camera propped up. So of course I said yes. And he said, cool. And I said, cool. And he walked into the physical therapy place. He left the drinking fountain on. Notice how he did that. I didn't notice that. Wow, that is so strange. Anyway, so yeah, stretching, minding my own business. He comes back out of the physical therapy place and proceeds to ask what my name was. And he said, I said Avery, and he said A-V-E-R-Y. And I don't know why I felt the need to correct this old man. So I said, no, A-V-R-E-Y. And then here he is telling me about how he tore his whatever the fuck, I don't even remember. God, I wish I could leave this audio in so bad. And then is basically saying, oh yeah, well, I have my physical therapy appointment, but by the time I come back out, you might be gone. So how about I get your number and I take you to dinner? And my first instinct was to say, I am too young for you, because he was old and I could not stop thinking, why is this older guy talking to me? And he proceeds to go, well, I'm too rich for you. And you can just see it on my face that I just could not believe that that happened. I have never been hit on at the gym before, and I see a lot of TikToks about girls being hit on at the gym, and I always think, oh, like I'm really lucky that that's never happened to me. And then literally the day
that I was going to talk about all of this stuff in a video that happens to me. But yeah, here's me now doing my little workouts. Today I was just doing a Pilates workout. I have a Pilates subscription to this thing called the Pilates class is what it's called. They just have a bunch of different Pilates things and I really like them. And some days I try and do more like weights or something a little bit more intense. And then other days I try and do things that are a little bit like slower and still intense and still make me sweaty and still make me burn a lot of calories, but just not like using weights really. So yeah, but yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say for this. But God, men, leave women alone in the gym. It's literally the last place where I would ever want to be hit on.
I'm getting my lashes tinted and lifted and my brows laminated. So here is before. Here is after. Oh my gosh, my lashes look so good. And the brows too, obviously, look so good.
My eyebrows right now look huge. I don't know if she dyed them. I don't think she did. There's a little bit of like residue on there, you know. I can't get them wet for 24 hours, but it is not going to look like this. Like, this is not the final product. I cannot believe how tall my eyebrows get, but oh my God, my lashes look so, so good. If you live in Northern Utah area, this is where I go. This place is bomb, has good service. They do a lot of different stuff. They do teeth whitening, they do tooth gems, eyebrows, lashes. The girl that I go to, her name is Brittany, and she is amazing and always does a really good job. Wasn't planning on doing this, but I just am sitting here and I feel like I haven't had a day by myself where I just go and do things by myself in a really long time. And my favorite ramen bar is up the road. So I think I'm gonna go there and get some ramen and maybe a lemonade. Hello? I feel like I'm trying to come up with a reason of why I can go and get ramen by myself, but I don't need one. I can just go and get it. It's getting really hot in here, so I'm gonna turn you off and the air on. It's a couple hours later. I'm looking on Pinterest for some photo inspiration for me and Jen's to just do a shoot with each other. It's like one of my favorite things to do is like come up with a concept and hair and makeup look and like go to a location and try and just take semi-creative photos. So yeah, I'm looking for inspiration for that right now. The past couple hours I've just been kind of doing whatever I feel like doing. I'm trying to get back into writing recently. I used to write a lot when I was in high school. Not anything like super poetic, but like even when I did essays, when it was things that I was passionate about, I genuinely enjoyed doing it. So I don't know, I think like starting to like write songs and just like little poems would be something that would be fun for me. So I'm taking this Skillshare class called Creative Writing for All, a 10-day journaling challenge, just to start off easy and I don't know, just see what I can learn. It had really good reviews. Emily Gold created the class, who is a writer and an author. So if you don't know what Skillshare is an online learning community where they have thousands of different classes for all different sorts of people that like to do a billion different things. They have so many classes, it's literally insane. But if you want to explore new skills or develop already interests that you're interested in, this is totally the place for you to go and do that. It's specifically curated for learning, so there's no ads. They're always launching new premium classes. They even just started doing live classes, so you can experience real life classes, which is really cool. So if you want to go check out Skillshare, the first 1,000 people to click the link in my description will get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare. So I highly recommend it. There's literally no loss. Go try and do something. Go try and learn something. Yeah, I highly recommend. I have taken so many Skillshare classes. I have learned so much from Skillshare and I will continue to do so. So go check it out. I think now is when I wanted to start talking about the whole food and body stuff that I mentioned a little bit earlier. A little bit of history with my workout journey and everything. Oh, a couple disclaimers because, you know, I don't want to make anyone upset or anything. I'm going to be talking about weight loss and changing my body and food and just all of that sort of stuff. So if anything like that is, you are sensitive to, maybe stop watching here. And that's totally fine. And here's a kiss for you. Also, I am not a nutritionist. I'm not a doctor. I'm not telling you to do anything at all. I don't know everything. I grew up being an athlete. I was a dancer and then I was a cheerleader until I moved up to Northern Utah. I completely stopped working out. I was going from exercising like 2 to 3 times a week, doing really intense like 2.5 not 2.5, maybe like 1.5 long cheer practices to not doing anything at all. And that really hurt me physically and mentally. I did gain weight. That's not a bad thing at all. I also just want to say weight gain is great. Weight loss, if you're just taking care of yourself, that is great. But yeah, I definitely gained weight and there was nothing wrong with that, but I wanted to change it because I wanted to, and I wanted to feel more confident. And you don't have to lose weight to feel confident about yourself at all, but for me that was the case. Well, I didn't have to, I just wanted to. It was something that I wanted to do. I wanted to get back into living like an active, healthier lifestyle because I wasn't healthy at the time. Not just because of my weight, I just wasn't healthy. I just wasn't being a healthy person. The first thing that I started doing is I started working out just in my room. I would use, I think my mom has like 8 and 10 pound weights. I just started using those, maybe even fives. I started doing BBG. This was before it was even an app. If you know what the sweat app is, that's what it's called. I was doing that pretty much. My mom had all the papers and stuff printed out and I would do that. And I think I lost like a little bit of weight from doing that. I did that for a while. Then I wanted to do something a little bit different. I started going to the gym. Didn't really have any idea of what I was doing in the gym. I don't even really have any memory of that. Not that I don't have memory. I don't remember what I was doing in the gym. Then I just started doing a couple different things. I worked out at home every once in a while. I started Orange Theory. I did that for a while. I stopped doing Orange Theory only because of COVID. Orange Theory was great because I burned a lot of calories, but their workouts weren't super targeted at all. So I feel like it didn't really change my body that much. I didn't want to be putting in like all of this work and like burning all of these calories and, you know, putting in the work to not actually be changing in the way that I wanted. So I stopped doing that. Then I went back to working out at home because of COVID and everything. Then last winter, I decided that I wanted to get a personal trainer because I wanted to, if you guys don't know this about me already, I really want to be a model. That's like my dream job. Has been since I was a kid. Not that you have to be skinny or anything or super lean to be a model by any means. I feel like this is all known. It was just something that I wanted to work on, was just getting more lean. I started in January into the new year. I started working with a new personal trainer and I didn't really have the best experience. I felt like they weren't really listening to exactly what I wanted because I was lifting super, super heavy weights and was being told to eat a lot of protein, which made me feel very sick. Like I just can't eat that much protein because it was way too heavy in my stomach. I was lifting super heavy weights to the point where like after a leg day, I would like be down for like the rest of the day because it was just way too much on my body. I had a really bad experience the last day that I ever went there. I was pulling into a parking lot, the gym parking lot, at the same time as this man, and he had a trailer, and the parking lot was kind of small, so I was like pulling in. I saw him coming in, so I stopped. But for some reason, he rolled down his window, and I like had no idea what he was going to say to me. So I rolled my window down, and he started cussing me out, like literally screaming at me, like calling me all of these names. I don't even want to like repeat exactly what he said because it literally was a little bit traumatizing. I'm scared of men and I hate when people yell. I walked into the gym after that and I was literally sobbing. I sat in the bathroom and I cried for like a long time, and my trainer didn't even show up. I don't know if there was like a miscommunication or what. That was a couple months ago. After that, I just knew that that was not the place for me to be. Then right after that, like that same day, I got a gym membership at the gym that I'm still going to now. I've done a lot of different things in between that, just like a couple times. Like I've taken a couple biking classes. I've done hot yoga a couple times. Not super consistently, but those were fun. I don't know. I enjoyed them. Anyway, so that kind of leads me to where I am now. I've been working out at the same gym for a good couple months now, and I am 100% still figuring it out. I don't have like a super set workout routine of what I do every single week, you know? I feel like something that I've really been struggling with is finding correct information for my goals. I feel like a lot of information I see is written about people who want to like gain a lot of muscle and like gain weight and muscle, and those just aren't necessarily my goals. So I feel like it's been kind of hard to find just information about like helpful things that I could be doing or workouts that I could be doing or whatever. Right now I'm kind of doing like 2 to 3 days of weights and 2 to 3 days of like more Pilates type things. Or if it's not Pilates, it's just like a body weight workout. Romy, the Victoria's Secret model, I really like her workouts. They're not like super intense or anything. The Pilates that I was doing earlier, that's kind of what I've been doing right now. I still have not like, I'm doing this, and this on Monday, and this, you know, it fluctuates all the time. And I'm still trying to figure it out. If I'm being honest, I don't have it 100% figured out. I wish I did, but I don't. out. On Instagram, I had you guys ask me a couple questions about anything regarding my fitness journey. So someone said, didn't grow up in a healthy family / eating healthy foods, any good easy things to make? So I think that's one thing that I feel really fortunate to have is that I grew up eating pretty healthy. My mom and my sister grew up vegetarian, so I eventually turned vegetarian. I have been for like 5 years now. And you know, everyone has their own definition of like what healthy eating is, but mine is like more plant-based stuff. That's just what makes me feel good. So that's like usually what I do. Pinterest will be your best friend. I get so many recipes from Pinterest, and I feel like advice I have for that is don't overcomplicate it. You don't have to find a recipe that has like 20 ingredients. Like find one that has like 8. Or less. I just have a board on Pinterest. I think it's private, so I don't know if you guys could even go and find it, but it's literally just called like vegan or like vegan recipes or something like that. And I have one for like breakfast, lunch, and dinner, a different category. And I try different recipes from there every once in a while. I think something that has really helped me is like finding consistent meals that I like to eat multiple times a week that I'm like okay with eating, that I really enjoy. So for example, I have breakfast. I have oatmeal like every day for breakfast because I really like it. Like I look forward to my oatmeal every day in the morning. Lunch, I have like avocado toast with like a protein bar, something similar like that. I eat like canned soup sometimes for dinner. Like you don't have to overcomplicate it. Even if you get like frozen things, frozen vegetables, frozen meals, do whatever you gotta do. I make like tacos a lot for dinner with like some vegan chicken nuggets and like some vegetables, and literally just put those in a tortilla and like some hot sauce and call it good. Just find like literally 2 to 3 things for like each meal that you can go back and forth between during the weeks. And when you get sick of it, find something else. Someone said, how do you make it not turn into something toxic when it comes to eating and working out? All of that, you know, can turn super toxic. And I have had my fair share of things turning toxic because I'm a human being and I am problematic sometimes, and I do things that I shouldn't do, and I think things that I shouldn't think, but that's just part of life, baby. I think something that I have had to reevaluate with myself several times is what my intentions are. If your intentions are unhealthy, maybe sit down and reevaluate. That's something that I've definitely had to do and to remind myself why I'm doing it. I think just literally like having small talks with yourself about why you're doing the things that you're doing can be really helpful. And just know that it's not worth it. Long-term unhealthy things are not worth it at all. That I'm just gonna say that because it's not. This question, how did you lose so much weight? I think I've lost like 15 pounds since like the very beginning of my workout thing, so like 4 years ago. Literally just eating healthy and working out. Just trying to be as active as possible, and I don't know, it can even be the most simple things. Like you don't even have to go to the gym. Like some days I won't feel like working out, so I'll just like go on a walk, or I'll just walk on the treadmill. Me and my boyfriend like to go on walks sometimes at night and get like ice cream or something, and you still get like 10,000 steps in. Eating in a calorie deficit, I'm not like super educated on that, so I'm not gonna talk that much about it, but I do that, or at least try, not every single day. There's such a science behind losing weight, and because everyone's body is so difficult, I feel like not one thing works for everyone. Like, you know, people are like, lift really heavy and eat a lot of protein and be in a calorie deficit to lose weight. And if that's the scientific way to do it, I literally don't know. I've gone through that phase where I was trying to do exactly that, and I just feel like more with the eating, it just didn't really make me feel good. I just try and eat a lot of fruits and vegetables and things that I consider healthy. This person said, my body is so weak, I can't complete any workouts, I hate myself. Don't hate yourself, because I think that's totally normal, especially when you're first starting. When I first started doing the very first workouts that I was doing, the ones on paper that my mom had when I would just do it at home. How those are set up is it's 28 minutes divided into 4 sections of 7. So it's 7 minutes, take a break, 7 minutes, take a break, and you know, 2 more sections of that. When I first started doing that, I could only do 7 minutes. I couldn't do any more than that, like for the first couple times, because I was just that like out of shape. So don't be down on yourself about that, because that's so normal, especially when you're first starting. Like I couldn't complete any workouts either. I still have times where I can't complete workouts. Like I'll make a workout routine for myself, like just for that day, and sometimes I skip like 1 or 2 of them because I'm tired and I'm over it and I just don't feel like doing it. It's just something that you have to build up. That obviously comes with consistency, so just keep trying and eventually your body will do that. Getting a lot of questions about motivation. You know, motivation is obviously a feeling that you can have, like if you like see someone working out on like a TikTok, be like, oh, like now I'm motivated to go and work out. 9 times out of 10, that emotion will literally last for like maybe 20 minutes. I don't even know. I feel like the best way that I can explain it is that you just have to do it. Like if you want to put the work in, you just have to go and do it. I saw this TikTok that someone asked like this girl the same question, like, how do you stay motivated? And I really liked her answer. And she said that she thinks of like going to the gym or like working out like an appointment. Like if you have a dentist appointment, it sucks and you don't want to go, but since it's important and you know you need to, you're going to go anyway. And she said that she thinks of the gym the same way. Like you just can't overthink it. Like you just have to think of it as like, I'm going to the gym. Obviously, if you're not feeling good or you're just really not feeling it, it's totally okay to take rest days. I do all the time. I would say I work out like 3 to 5 times a week, sometimes 6 maybe. I feel like 4 is usually like my golden number. Yeah, it's not about feeling a certain way. It's literally just the fact that you have to go and do it. Someone said you work out to look a certain way. So aesthetics obviously is a reason why people work out. It's a reason why I work out. I want my body to look a certain way, and I don't think there's anything wrong with that as long as you're just trying to be healthy and make good choices and stuff. But a lot of it, like the top reason I think I exercise and work out is for my mental health, because it really, really helped me when I was really, really depressed. I feel like since then, I just kind of can't look back now. Like I think I have a really good relationship with exercise. I'm really lucky for that, and it's taken me a long time to get to where I am now. I've said that a million times, but the majority of people work out to look a certain way, and there's nothing wrong with that. But I also do it for a lot of other reasons too. Someone said, did you study health and fitness? Literally no. I try and do as much research as I can. I feel like there's so much misinformation out there that it's really hard to figure out what to trust. I've seen so many different doctors and nutritionists be like, intermittent fasting is not healthy and it's not good for you, whatever. And then I saw a TikTok today of a doctor being like, here's why you should do intermittent fasting. Like, you just never know, and everyone has different opinions on everything, and it's totally fine. But no, I didn't study it. That's why I said I'm not giving anyone advice or telling anyone what to do. This is just my personal journey, and I try and do my research, but it is hard when I feel like there's a lot of misinformation out there. Someone said, how can I slowly start transitioning into working out? What do I do? So if you're talking about going to the gym, because you know, there's a lot of different forms of exercise, like you could do hot yoga a couple days a week. Maybe even start with things like that. Like if you just want to take like some classes at the gym, or like biking classes or anything like that. But if you're talking more about going to the gym, I think just going and definitely have a plan, even if it's literally a 20-minute workout. I did a 20-minute workout earlier. You don't have to go and like work out for 50 minutes at all. Like I literally did a 20-minute workout earlier. Just start small. Start like walk on the treadmill for 10 minutes and find like 3 arm workouts to do with 5 pound weight. I'm like a very all or nothing thinker. That was something that was kind of hard, is that I felt like I had to get in the gym and be doing these super intense things and have it all figured out, but that's not true at all. I'm still figuring it out. Some days I take it more easy than others, but yeah, I would just say start small. They said, what do I start with? Start with whatever you want, whether it's working mostly on machines or free weights or whatever. Maybe go with a friend. That could be really helpful too. I had a time where I went to the gym with a friend. She's probably not watching this, but she's like so in shape now. We're not super close anymore. If you're watching this, hey girl, you probably know who you are. She's like a bodybuilder now, and she looks amazing. So you never really know what it could turn into. So yeah, maybe go with a friend or someone. But this one's interesting. How much of it happened until you started seeing it? I feel like I never really did see it, because obviously the change is so slow that like there was never one day where I was like, wow, I look a lot different than I did 2 years ago. Like when I was looking at old pictures, I was like, wow, I do look pretty different, and I didn't even realize how different that I actually looked, because you literally just take it one day at a time. When it comes to like seeing results, I recommend to take progress pictures. I wish that's something that I did more of. I have a folder literally my phone called progress that I took maybe like 8 photos in like 2 years ago. So I'm not very good at taking progress photos. I definitely wish that I did more, but I feel like that's a really good way to just track your progress and also like how you feel, obviously. Someone said, what happened to your health and fitness account? You will see next year. Okay, someone said, what do you eat every day? So that's something that I am always really interested in when I see people who have similar like aesthetics that I want. I always wonder what they eat in a day. So I totally get why people ask me what I eat in a day. But I mean, I pretty much said like a bunch of different stuff that I eat. I snack on like fruits and vegetables and hummus and like wheat thins and protein bars. I don't know. I'm not really a snack person. Like I just kind of have like my 3 meals of the day. And for a snack, I have like a piece of chocolate. Literally every day. It's like my favorite thing. I sit on my couch at the end of the day and have like 2 pieces of chocolate. My grandma put me on. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I could do like some TikToks or something, or like Instagram stories of like what I'm eating in a day. I feel like food is such a sensitive thing. Like you say something that you eat and people point out like 10 reasons of like why it's problematic. Someone said, how do I get bored of workout playlists? I don't even have a workout playlist. I listen to like, literally I'll work out to like Lorde. I don't know why, it just doesn't really affect me. I feel like I can still get my workout done and listen to whatever I want to. So yeah, I'd be like literally listening to the most random shit when I'm working out. Okay, I think that's it. I feel like I answered a good amount of questions. My camera's also about to die, but I just wanna say, just keep in mind that a lot of things you see online are, I don't wanna say they're not real, but for example, like I could have a picture where my stomach looks so toned and good and whatever, and then 30 minutes later, if I literally am in a different position or I drink water or I eat something, I will look completely different. Yeah, I don't know. That was just my personal experience.